All right, so we're in the home stretch. Here's what we're doing today. You can see here, top piece in red is the sun visor. You put that on if you're not going to use the roof. The kit was missing one of the sun visors, so I have to make my own, and that's what this clear piece is. I found some clear styrene that was about the right thickness. I just kind of copied it the best I could. And then cut it out, and that's where that is. We're going to take that out, and we're going to prime it, and then get it ready for paint. That's what that is. So that's one step closer. The next thing I told you about earlier was that I was stressing over making the phone for the car. As you know, Dantana had a phone in his car, and he was, you know, it was a whole thing about that part of the show. He's always using the phone and everything is pretty cool. So this is the 70s and he's using a cell phone in his car. So I was stressing out how to do this and make it in scale. Then I was going through a parts box, actually looking for parts, styrene parts to make the sun visor, when I came across this. I don't know what this is from. I honestly don't recall. Focus. Doesn't want to focus, of course not. But it is obviously a radio. So I figured, well, this is probably more detailed than anything I can make, and it's definitely in scale. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this for my phone, but what I'll do is I'll take off the mic and the wire, and I'll just use the foam piece, mount this and detail it, paint it, you know, all that stuff, mount it in the car, and then I'll scratch build the handheld receiver, and I'll put that on a seat. And so that's what I think we're going to do. All right, close enough, because you know what? All the research I've done looking for the phone for Dantana, can't find the phone. You always see the handset, but never the actual radio itself. I even looked for mobile radios for 1978. I couldn't find anything with that either, at least not anything like his. So I figured this will work good. It's just a matter of painting it and being able to mount it in a car, because everything's already mounted in the interior. It's going to be a little difficult to get that in, but we'll figure that out. So that's where we are with that. It should work. Close enough for this project. Okay, so that's where we are. Hey guys, welcome back to Dirk's Pneumophiles. What we're looking at here is the completed build of the 57 T-Bird, as seen in the TV series Vegas, driven by Robert Urich, aka Dan Tana, the number one private detective in Vegas. I'm surprised this kit ended up getting finished. It was a beast. This kit was really, really a beast. So many issues derived from the kit itself, so many derived from my skills. It was just a pain in the testes. But in the end, I guess I got something that kind of looks like the Dantana car. I'm not very pleased with it overall, but it's better than nothing. It'll look decent on the shelf from a distance. But yeah, it's been trouble from the beginning. Paint was an issue. Part fit was an issue. My skills created other issues, not test fitting stuff before painting and glossing over stuff. It was just a train wreck. And then it just escalated from there. And you can see here how the front grille just doesn't line up properly. Had I checked that out earlier, would have been great. Instead, I waited until the car was painted and I put it in, and I'd never even noticed it. It's just ugly. Let's see if we can zoom in here. Hold on a second. Yeah, the fit was horrible. The part count was horrible. The decals, the stickers, actually they weren't decals, they were stickers for the wheels, was horrible. I never painted white on tires before, but I think after this I'm going to have to learn, because it was just abysmal. The details, such as the emblems on it, were so soft and undescript. It just, the paint makes it look even worse. It was just bad. Fender flares didn't fit. The fender skirts didn't fit properly, so I had to adjust those. You can see the sticker starting to peel off here already, giving me an issue. What else? We talked about the paint already. It's just the thickness of the windshield was just awful. Let's see. We got the underside. We got a big hair there. The underside. Nothing special. Just basic colors. No real weathering to it. It's Vegas. Wouldn't need a lot of weathering. Take the hood off too. The engine, again, nothing special there. I didn't wire it, just put it in, painted it, that was about it. Let's see. The box, even though the box says it's the Dantana car, they didn't do anything to make it the Dantana car, except for the license plate sticker to say Tana. They didn't give you the aerial, they didn't give you the phone, none of that. So I had to make that myself. So additional pieces that we made was the aerial antenna here for the back. So you can see that. That. White. There you go. That was made with an antenna for armored vehicles, actually. I got that in a parts lot that I bought. So I thought that was a perfect fit for that, so that worked out well. We added a radio antenna to the car. It had a radio antenna. Again, I think the cars today, most people build cars today and they don't put it on. I think it's just something that stands out to me. So we put that in, and of course, because it's still pointy, it acts as a deterrent for people trying to pick up the model, touch it, because I've gotten stuck countless times after I put it in place. Let's see what else. The big thing that we did here, you can see here, is we put in the radio. I found a radio in my parts box. I don't know what it was from. It was a regular police radio, though. So I cut off the microphone, cut off the wire. We painted it, put it in the car, because to the best of my knowledge, at least I've been going through the series now. I'm in season 2, and I've yet to see what the base looks like. Okay? All you ever see is the handset. So that's my interpretation of it, and that's what I use. So I painted it off white. This way it adds contrast and interest to the rest of the interior. Added a wire to it, and then made a custom handset there. Okay, it's hard to see against the white, but that too is painted off white, and the ear and mouthpieces are black on it, which is the way it was in the TV show too. So I just laid that on the seat. Also I added the vent windows here on the side. The kit didn't come with it. I just used the tin of a takeout container. Added some styrene on the top, across the top and the side of it for the chrome. Glued that into place. Because the windshield is so thick, it just stuck to it without a problem. I was supposed to also, if you remember, I was working on the sun visors. Problem is, the sun visors, here's one here. They were just so thick when I put it in place, it didn't look right. And I made a custom one to match it. And again, put it in place, and it wasn't too bad, but it just didn't look right. It was too thick. So I decided to take them out. Besides, if you've seen the car, on the show, I've never seen the sun visor, so I'm not too worried about it. You can see here the mating where the chrome meets the windshield is just horrible. Ugh. Oh, this is a despicable build. It really is. I'm showing it, but I have to admit, I'm kind of embarrassed about it. It's that ugly of a car. Not car, but model. Ugh. But again, it's a show that I really like. It's from an actor that I, my favorite actor, so I had to build it anyway. I wouldn't recommend this kit to anybody. Although, if I was to come across one, I might build it again, just knowing what I know and how to attack things differently. But still, in the end, it's still going to be a smoldering piece of crap in the end. So, you know, it is what it is. But, there you have it. The Dantana 57 Thunderbird, as seen in TV show Vegas. Thanks for those that stuck around for this build. I know it was a hard one to sit through. You guys deserve a medal if you stuck through to the end. So until next time, guys, be strong.